Yesterday I showed the process of me making this pigment. It's copper acetate. I did a cool little time lapse of me making it. I maybe it's just me, but I thought it was really cool to watch it, so maybe go watch it if you haven't seen it. Anyways, a lot of you were concerned about my health while I made this, and I want to reassure you, I did learn a few things for future science experiments from the comments, but in general, I did do all the safety precautions, just in case you were curious. Sorry, my toddler's playing peekaboo with a squeaky door. But next chemistry paint experiment, I'm gonna show you how to make paint with batteries. Not that you should do it, but you can.
You've been studying your chemistry?
No.
Did you at least memorize the periodic table?
A, B, C, D.
No. Okay. Number one is hydrogen. Number
okay,
two.
Bye.
No.
No Nuance November, Scientist Edition. GMOs aren't inherently bad for you, essential oils won't cure cancer, and COVID is not the flu. Juice cleanses are a fad that will not detox your body. Cold temperatures alone won't make you sick, that theory's shoddy. The tryptophan in turkey isn't what is making you sleepy, it's the enormous amount of food and sweets that you have just been eating. Vaccines don't cause autism, no one's hiding the cure for cancer. Come learn some science with me, not from memes and influencers.
Do you know that this is in your body? It's a cell called laminin, and it literally holds you together. It keeps you from falling apart. And I'm sure you noticed that its shape is a cross, just like the cross that Jesus Christ died on. So look what the Bible says and how this all ties together. The Bible says that Jesus existed before anything else, and he holds all creation together. He literally holds you together, just like laminin. There's no coincidence here. Share this amazing fact with somebody.
Okay, so I'm officially so confused and a little bit afraid. I was just sitting in my car and I seen a TikTok a while ago of a girl taking a picture of the sky and then putting down like all these different settings, and then you could like see the stars, right? So I tried it in my car sitting in the parking lot. Didn't think it was gonna work or anything, but I did it out of my sunroof. Just took a picture of that right there without this light in it. I used portrait mode, took a picture of the blackness right there. And when I messed with and edited the picture just on my iPhone, just turn up the brilliance and stuff, this is what it did. Okay, so this is the picture. I zoom in and I'll show you what it's looking like. Does that not look like a microchip to you? And does that not look like someone wearing a goddamn clown mask? What? This straight up looks like a motherboard out of a computer, bro. I'm so confused.
I want to bring your attention to this organ right here called the liver. And specifically, running right down essentially the center of it is a piece of connective tissue called the falciform ligament, which is going to separate that left and right lobe of the liver, but it's also going to anchor the liver to the inside of your abdomen.
What insane stat lives in your head rent-free?
What's shaking, bacon? I've been waiting for this one. Did you know that when you shuffle a deck of cards, you are most likely holding a combination of cards that has never existed before and probably will never exist again? Here's why. There are 52 cards in a standard deck, so all possible combinations will be a factorial of 52. So 52 is multiplied by 51, 50, 49, all the way down to 1. Do you have any idea how big that number is? It's this big. Think of it this way. If you were to shuffle a new combination every nanosecond, which is 1 billionth of 1 second, it would take you this many years to get every possible permutation.
Bruh.
What is the closest planet to the sun, Trisha?
Who cares about space and gravity?
Literally, who does, though?
Who cares? We don't need gravity.
Mars.
I'm sorry, it is Mercury.
That's some bullshit.
It's not. Everybody knows that.
You take a piece of ordinary pipe and fill it with liquid and put a plunger at both ends. Any blow on one plunger sends the other plunger flying out. Liquids can't be compressed, so here's what happens inside. the power of your blow is transferred to the other plunger by hydraulic transfer of power. This is the simplest kind of hydraulic system. Bending the pipe doesn't affect this transfer of power at all. It goes around corners just the same.